If you're shooting an SLOG3 but you're struggling with your color grading, then this video is for you. Because in this tutorial, I'll take you step by step through my color grading process. And the clip we'll be grading today is a shot I took in Ubud, Bali, of a man walking through the rice fields. But before we start grading, in the description, there's a download link. And when you click on the link, you'll go to a folder where you'll find a raw clip and the conversion LUT, which we'll use during one of the color grading steps. So make sure to download the asset so we can color grade together. Let's quickly talk about three benefits of shooting an SLOG3. The first one being better dynamic range. This means that you'll be able to capture more detail in the highlights and the shadows of your footage, which can particularly be useful in high contrast situations, such as shooting during bright daylight. The second one is having more flexibility in post-production. Because SLOG3 captures more dynamic range than traditional gamma curves, it gives you more flexibility in post-production to adjust the exposure, the contrast, and also the color of your footage without losing any detail or introducing noise. And the third one is just a better overall color grading. Because SLOG3 provides a flat, desaturated image that's ideal for color grading. Because with a flatter image, you have more latitude to push the colors in different directions and achieve the desired look for your project. Well, it can take some time to get the hang of it. Once you do, you'll soon be wondering why you didn't start shooting an SLOG3 earlier. Believe me. Okay, enough talking, let's start color grading. Okay, step one is the conversion LUT. I already have the clip on my timeline. And first we have to open the color panel. Then I go up to creative and I'm going to import my conversion LUT. I really like the Airy 01, so that's the one we're going to work with today. I choose to import the LUT at the creative tab because there's an intensity slider. Here you can easily adjust the intensity of the conversion LUT. Now that that's done, we duplicate the Lumetri color layer and we reset all its settings. Then we move on to step number two, exposure and curves. I'm now going to work on the curves, and the curves really depend on the image you're working with and the look you want to create. I'm going for a mood dark green look today, and like this I think it will work. Then we move on to the U versus U curve. So the U versus U slider is a color correction tool that allows you to adjust the U of specific colors in your footage. I select two points on the slider and choose a point kind of in the middle. Doing it this way creates a smooth roll-off in the colors. And I want to push the greens a bit more towards the blues, so I drag it down. And like this, it looks good. Up next is the U versus Luma slider. This curve lets you adjust the hue and brightness of your color. In this case, I want deep dark green, so I'm going to drag it down just a little bit. And the last one is the U versus saturation slider. This slider is a tool that allows you to adjust the saturation of specific colors in your footage. I want a little bit less saturation in the green, so I'm going to drag this one down as well. So let's toggle this Lumetri color layer on and off to see what we've created so far. It's looking great, but we can make it look even better. I'm going to duplicate the Lumetri color effect again and reset its settings. Then we move on to step three, which is masking. I want the viewer to be drawn to the middle, to the path where the man is walking. To do so, I'm going to create a rough mask around the path. And when I change the exposure, you can see that the path in the middle of the screen becomes darker. But we want the outside to be darker, so we invert the mask. It looks horrible, but look what happens when I adjust the feather. I think I can drag the exposure down a little bit more. And that's the final look. Let's have a look at the final clip. And now let's turn off all the layers and go step by step to see the difference. So step one was the conversion LUT. Step two was the curves, and step three was the masking. So I'm very happy with how this grade turned out, and I really like making these kinds of videos, and hopefully you can learn something from the way I color grade. And I'm thinking of making this into a little series where I color grade all different kinds of footage. So let me know if you would be interested in seeing more videos like this. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.